bass.
Oh yes, big.
Big fish.
But no matter what you've caught, or even what you've seen, there is always a bigger fish, a tougher fish. And it's out there. It's out there somewhere. Oh, got a strike. Yep, I got one.
Woo-hoo! That's a beauty, mate. That's a tuna. Go, Max, go.
Yeah, ain't f***ing around with little tunas here. They're going to rip your arms off.
There you go. You just ate it. Woo! OK, we've got one. Holy f***, just keep an eye on that. It's spin out of control. Oh. For centuries here in Niue, the local fishermen have been taking their tiny craft out into these deep, wide blue waters. And it's out here that they've fished for the wahoo, the yellowfin tuna, and even marlin. It's such an important part of life that it's become almost a spiritual thing for these fishermen. And it's this that I want to immerse myself in, learn the ways that have been passed down from generation to generation. However, we've only got a couple of hours this morning and paddling sucks, so I'll see you out there. Well, here's a classic example of how a fad works. I mean, we're out here in hundreds of metres of deep blue water and we've got all these mackerel bait fish around here, and these mackerel are eaten by just about everything. I've got one live down deep with a sinker on, and I've got one floating on a bottle out the back there, so surely I've got to get a bite here, surely.
Now all the bait fish just suddenly disappeared. There's a sign, there's a big fish in there somewhere.
Yep, bit. Yes, I'm bit. I'm bit. Something's eating my live bait. Oh, I just let it go, whatever it was.
Huh. Whoa! Wahoo!
Wahoo, you reckon?
Yeah. Straight through it.
So what do you reckon, live? Wire then? Beautiful baits. Yep. I'm getting bit. Okay, that is going very fast. I was just rigging up a bit of wire leader, and that was why I was rigging up wire. Whatever it was, just bit through. See, I'm already on the job, rigging up a bit of wire leader. I went to a heavier mono that time, 150 pound, but even 150 pound fluorocarbon's no match for the jaws on these wahoo. See what the verdict is. Chomp.
Bugger.
Okay, let's go again.
I'm tied up to a FAD, or fish aggregation device. It's basically a series of floats and palm fronds anchored to the seabed to create a floating structure that becomes shelter for bait fish, which then attracts larger predators like these wahoo. Without these FADs, it would be difficult for local canoe fishermen to find fish out here in the wide, deep blue ocean. And the wahoo are a favourite food here in Niue, prized for not only their delicate, tasty flesh, but revered for their incredible speed and strength. Their razor-sharp teeth easily cut through fishing line, and this wahoo displays the hook it has sliced off a fisherman's line. Perhaps it's the one I lost earlier, but since changing to wire leader, I've not had another bite.
Well, didn't have a heck of a lot of luck here, unfortunately, at the man-made fish aggregation device. However, there are natural FADs, fish aggregation devices, structures, that you can take advantage of. And there's one right there, Niue Island. Might just drift a bait or two along there for a little while. But as you can see, I've got a couple of live baits out. And while the land's right there, I'm in about 150 metres of water here, and I'm hoping there'll be some big pelagics cruising along this edge that'll pick up one of my baits. Yo, I've got him on!
Oh yeah, whoa!
Oh. Just lost it! Just lost it. Bugger. I might actually go back in and do that drift again.
There's got to be a doggy here, so I'm going to troll along this ledge with a bait.
I'm determined to catch a big fish off this jet ski, so I've rigged a bait to try for the meanest fish on the reef.
Come on, you punk, eat it!
The dogtooth tuna.
Oh, come on.
He's got one, Go. Dropped it. Those tooth holes don't look like it could have been a dog tooth tuna, maybe. Close, but no cigar. Oh well, with that, we better move on to our next thing. Quickly!
I'm going the traditional way today. I'm going to be handline fishing from this, a vaka, my outrigger canoe. Oh, got a strike. Yep, I got one. This is heating up my hands. Ay, ay, ay. Whoa!
So to catch up with the latest tips and techniques, as well as our latest fishing action, check out ultimatefishing.tv and download the Ultimate Fishing app, so wherever you go, you've got access to our entire catalogue of tips, rigs, techniques, and location information. And it's all available free at ultimatefishing.tv.
Well, my little foray into pioneering some extreme jet ski fishing in Niue didn't work out terribly well, so I'm going the traditional way today. I'm taking a leaf out of the book of the locals, and I'm going to be handline fishing from this, a vaka, my outrigger canoe, and I'm going to be getting a lesson from two master vaka fishermen. I might learn a thing or two and perhaps catch a very big fish on a hand line out of my vaka here.
Not only am I going to learn from these guys about vaka fishing today, I'm also competing with them in their annual vaka fishing tournament.
Yep, he's got one.
And by the sounds of things, they're into some action already.
Fight it. Holla. Oh, loose it. Hake do ton. Ayo. Hey. Mare vayo. Oh, he's Mr. Hollywood, famous guy. Oh, Mr. Tom Cruise.
It seems ribbing your mates while out in a fishing competition is the same wherever you go. And that's another reason to get out fishing, for pure enjoyment. And these guys certainly know how to enjoy themselves and get some great seafood at the same time.
Oh, moi.
There's some whales coming. Yeah, two humpbacks. Awesome.
Woo.
Oh, yeah.
Mince. That means a piece of steak, mince.
Oh, yeah, that guy over there is hooked up. The noise he's making is anything to go, boy. It's a good one.
Good on him, mate. That's what we want.
Primo. Is it big enough to win the competition? So, what's the technique, master?
I just lost one, right?
Oh, you just lost one. You had a bite.
Yep.
Oh, it's got a bite now.
Ah, oh, lost it, mate.
Oh, really?
Yeah. Gosh.
Yeah. Oh.
Lost it.
So are you just using a small chunk of bait?
Yeah.
Okay, right, I'm into it. He's just had a bite already, see? Today, I am grasshopper. This is Sensei. Daniel's son, Mr. Miyagi. Obi-Wan, Luke Skywalker. You get the picture. I'm here to learn. I need all the help I can get, bro.
There you go, Matt. That's your share.
Oh, so there's some chum you're throwing out there.
Yep. Yes. Yeah, it may be a bottom one, eh?
A bottom fish?
Yeah, because we are putting a lot of...
A lot of chum.
Chum, and they're coming up.
And the chum goes to the bottom and the bottom fish come up?
Yeah.
Ah, I see. Now, I've fished in a lot of fishing tournaments in my time, but never one where I've been quite so out of my depth.
It looks like a tuna, mate. It's a tuna.
It's a tuna.
It's a tuna, mate.
Well, you were just hauling it in. Ah, oh, it is too. A yellowfin tuna.
Yep.
Hey. Yeah. Look at it, mate. Oh, well done. The master, eh?
Yep. Bang, bang, bang.
Far
bang,
out.
Bang, bang, bang.
And do you catch big yellowfin out of your vaka as well?
Yes, sure. Thank you, buddy. Wah, wah, wah.
Oh, brilliant. Yep, he's done that before, right? I've got to get a bait and I've got to get some of this action. So I'm just throwing out some cubes, yeah?
Yeah, just put it down to 60 or 70, eh?
Yep. So, Ricky, I see Poi banging the side of his vaka.
Yes, that's a code.
Oh, it's a code, is it?
Yeah.
Oh, doing Morse code to the fish.
Yes.
But in fact, what's actually happening, there's some science in that. Tuna, well, all predatory fish, they have a lateral line that picks up vibration. And of course, we're in a big, deep, wide open ocean here, and it's that banging, perhaps, that just tweaks one of the sensors of the tuna to come and investigate. They might see the chunks that Ricky's been throwing out, and then make the mistake of eating a chunk with a hook in it. Hopefully my one. Oh, I've got a strike. Yep, I got one.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Go, go,
Matt! Whoa! Whoa! Woohoo! Holy smokes! This is heating up my hands.
I know, mate.
Ay, ay, ay.
That's a beauty, mate. That's a tuna.
This is awesome, man. See, it's a tried and true technique is the cubing for tuna. The most rudimentary sort of fishing. A hook, a hand line, and a chunk of bait. And I've got a fish on. Yeah.
Go, Matt, go.
This is awesome. With a hand line, you're just one to one. You get to feel the real McCoy. Every beat of the tail, it's awesome. A few kicks there, starting to kick pretty hard. Well, I've got some colour down there now. It's doing big circles, just like a tuna would. It is a tuna. Yeah! Now that's my next trick. Oh, it's doing those big deep circles. I can feel those head shakes going, just arcing around. This is where all the stretch has gone out of the line. And as it's circling around, just got to be careful it doesn't break that line or tip me over. Oh, I'm trying to tail it, but I don't want to play ball. Yippee! Aha! Whee!
Big bag.
Yeah, boy! Yeah. So there you go. Not only was that a whole lot of fun, but this sort of fishing for these fish out of these deep waters has been done for centuries. and this is going to supply some fantastic food. Unfortunately, we don't see yellowfin tuna so much, particularly in New Zealand anymore, but when you can come out here and catch one, and it's such an important part of their culture and sustenance.
Matt, still alive, mate.
Okay. And that's probably a good indicator of how important it is for sustenance. My master over here, Ricky, is telling me to give it another whack. He wants me to make sure of it, because while I'm having good fun, this still is an important food source, and I've got to make sure of it. Is that okay now, boss?
Still moving.
Don't worry, mate. He's coming home for food. I ain't letting him go. Yeah. On the board. Yeah.
Omoi, omoi, omoi.
What's that song you're singing, Ricky?
Well, it's just calling the fish. It's one way of talking to them.
I suppose you'd know them all by name.
Oh, most of them, it's got my name on it.
As I've been going, I've been, of course, watching Poi and Ricky and how they fish. And as we're drifting along, there's current and the vuck is drifting. So it's important to let your bait sink down naturally. So you've got to tend to your line at the same time. So they're just sort of holding the paddle in one hand and feathering it. And it's just a way to hold yourself stationary and just guide the boat while you're tending to your line. I'm not doing it nearly as good as they are, but I'm doing my best. The obvious solution, you might say, is, well, put a sinker on. You put a sinker on and all of a sudden that chunk of bait that you've got down there isn't naturally floating through the water column with the other chunks, and it won't get eaten. The tuna will simply avoid it. Ricky?
Yes?
The current's picked up?
Yeah, it's picking up, and it's... I mean, I don't favour this current this time.
Yeah, well, it is going to be hard to get the baits down. It's really quite interesting, like listening to Ricky and Poi and the other guys. I guess being in the vaka, so close to the elements, no electronics, no fancy lures, you really have to be in tune with what's going on. The currents, the tides, the angle of the sun, all of these things. It's the most valuable lesson in fishing, is to keep your eyes and your ears open all the time. Not just when you're catching fish, but also when you're not catching fish. Well, we're out of time for our tuna fishing because we've got to get back to the ramp, catch up with the other guys in the vuckers, and see how my fish measures up with the ones that they've caught in the local vucker fishing tournament. Oh no!
Sorry, buddy. Sorry, mate.
Oh! Oh, there's a big fish on the end of my hand line. Holy show! We're just about out of line.
I'm in a fishing competition in Niue, where all the participants fish with hand lines from their traditional bucket canoes.
No worries, mate. I got it covered, mate, I got it covered. Oh, no!
Sorry, buddy.
Isn't that awesome that these guys can go out in their vaka and catch yellowfin tuna? You know, just like a delicacy. What a treat, man. What a morning. It's awesome. These people are awesome. Well done, bro.
And now it's time to weigh the fish and find out how I measured up against the local fish.
Ooh. 15, eh? We'll call, we'll better let the weighmaster do it. I better stay out of it.
No, we'll call it 15.
Yeah.
Oh, 15.5. That's a good one. First place for heaviest fish caught today, it was a tie between two. So this award goes out to Yoala Mangtungye, who's also our youngest fisherman.
Yeah.
Or Sini.
Sini!
15.5. So you're trying to say 0.5 heavier than mine?
Sorry, mate.
Don't jump in the water.
It's got to be a local, mate.
Now, without a word of a lie, this has been the greatest fishing competition I've ever been in. Yahoo!
My experience handlining for tuna in Niue has left me wanting more. So I've taken my trusty electric fence reel handline all the way to Nova Scotia, Canada, to try and catch one of the mightiest of all tuna, the Atlantic giant bluefin tuna. To get a feel for the Atlantic bluefin, we spent a week catching these giants with Nova Scotia's very own mad fisherman, Captain Dale Trentham.
That fish is in trouble.
Oh, that's a tuna! That's a tuna!
After an incredible few days getting to know the giant bluefin tuna,
I'm getting in.
It's now time for me to hang up my wetsuit, put away the modern fishing tackle, and see if I can overcome one of these giants with nothing more than a hand line.
Come on, Old Faithful.
So our first bait is in the water, and now all we have to do is wait.
Get my gloves, someone grab my gloves for me.
It scared the shit out of me.
Well, we're just getting set up.
The hell was that? Float's gonna go ripping out. Okay, Dave? Okay, so you can get some real good shots. Here we go. Oh.
I'm shaking.
You're shaking? Bro, I'm about to go toe-to-toe with 1,000 pounds of tuna on my hands.
This is wild.
This is wild. What's that bait there, Dave? That bait there.
Oh,
yeah, that herring just got eaten. That herring just got eaten there.
He'll be back. Oh, he came up again, see it?
No, I wasn't watching. Oh, look at the swirl. See, I mean, that was about 4 or 5 seconds after he went past. You can see that big boil. That gives you some idea of the amount of water there displacing the pressure. Watch that herring. He's going to get it. Oh, there he is. It's a big one too. This time though, there's just the one fish. There's not a whole pack of them, so they're not being competitive. He doesn't need to be as aggressive. He's just coming through and he's picking up these herrings. There he goes, he just ate it. Spit it out and need to maybe keep more weight on it to set the hook. He ate it, man, he ate it. Holy smokes, bro. That was a big
shaking. I'm shaking too. I'm not supposed to do that.
Let's get ready. We are going to get hooked up.
Oh man, I wanted to be hooked up then. Bit of weight on it this time.
I'll hold on to it this time.
Yeah, set that hook.
Oh, he's flashed at it again. Look, he's going to take it.
Pull the weight, some weight. Okay, we've got him on. Holy f***, just keep an eye on that, doesn't spin out of control. Nah, we pulled the hook on him.
Put your hands.
Pulled the hook, I think.
We certainly weren't ready for that. We were still setting up the tackle and cameras when the tuna swooped in past our bait. And when it decided to eat, it came in with such speed and force, it was like a bomb had detonated in the water right next to us. Then the float ripped out at tremendous speed. In just seconds, it pops up 100 metres away. The inertia created by the immense acceleration has snapped the strong polypropylene rope that is strong enough to tow a car.
Broke the cord.
So it's time for me to re-rig, regroup, and perhaps re-evaluate if what we're trying to do is even possible.
A smaller float.
You ain't gonna slow him down.
He's a master.
Yeah, just if someone could be hanging, sticking around just because of, with a knife, in case I can't get to this fast enough if I get, because just if that flies to bits, it might spit a whole lot of loose line at me. And yeah, that's not going to be good. You see what happened there? I've got no chance of staying in the boat.
Yeah, ain't f***ing around with little tunas here. They're going to f***ing rip your arms off.
Thank you.
We're a little bit more prepared this time, just making sure I've got a safety knife.
We're now a little more prepared for the tuna. The trouble is, this clear, calm water is not ideal now that the sun's up high, because it allows the wily tuna to see the line, even when it's suspended in the air. So the giant tuna just cruised by, eating our chum and passing up our baits.
Oh, there he is, big fish. I make a mistake eventually. Killing me. I don't know if I've ever been so anxious about anything. I mean, just watching him drive by. You know, just cruise past. Big beast. Oh, he got it, there he is. He ate the herring.
There he is. Oh my Jesus. Hang on to your gloves.
Here he goes. Oh! Oh, he pulled off at the last second. He's a beast too. He is a beast. There's two here? Oh, that's good. There's two fish here now. So we might get them competing.
Didn't see.
Yeah, oh, there he goes again. He's just passed by it again.
Big boy. We're getting them hungrier.
Oh, oh, oh. He's big. He's big. Oh, look at the size of it.
Oh, look at the one below.
Oh, yeah. Now there's a few there.
He's on it.
Oh, he just ate that chunk there. Here he is. Straight down here under the bait. Come on, eat it, buddy, eat it.
These giants are teasing me. My heart rate increases with every pass. The trouble is, the longer we sit here, the less likely it is that we'll fool one of these fish into taking our baits.
Playing with giants.
Giants playing with us.
Well, should we switch to we switch our chum to the shady side? And then that light might not be hitting the leader.
We've tried everything today, but we may have missed our chance earlier this morning. So we'll have to finish up the day with no fish, having been outfoxed by the giant bluefin tuna.
Okay, let's get out of here. Do it all over again tomorrow.
It's hardly a chore.
So it's come down to our last day in Nova Scotia to see if it really can be done.
Right, the all-important part of the day, which will probably determine how the rest of our day goes, and that is how many herring we get, getting that fresh bait. It's just so vital to our chances of catching a tuna. Please, herring, please. Some? Oh, not many. Not many at all. That's not even a snack. It's like a peanut for one of those tuna. Not enough bait. Let's catch some liveies. That's what we'll do. Get lemons, you make lemonade. Wise man once told me.
As long as we get a half a dozen nice ones, that's all we care.
That's what we want now, Matt!
Oh, yeah!
It's like commercial bait catching here.
Let's get out of here.
Oh, yeah!
We'll leave that bait, whatever's in it, in it.
Blackfish.
What was that?
Blackfish.
Blackfish?
Yeah, right here.
They see our net. Look, blackfish all around us. The tuna's right here.
Tuna gotta be here? Okay.
Right here, right now.
We've got the blackfish, aka the pilot whales around us, and the big tuna run with these guys. So, we're getting our kite up. We're gonna get our bait out.
Looking at our net, see? It's a magnet. Magnet. For whales and tuna. Look, feasting, they're hungry. That was a tuna, wasn't it? There's tuna around us.
Seen one? Or you sensing them?
Yeah, I seen a fin. Look, see the tuna, look.
tuna.
There was a tuna there, was it?
Oh, yeah.
Far out. Okay. Oh, man.
What's this?
Tunas, yeah, the fins on them. Watch that bait there.
Watch that bait.
There, it's gone.
That's tuna. No whale does that. We are going to get hooked up.
You ready, Matt?
Am I ready? Well, let's see.
Look at the whales. That's a tuna, look.
No time to really get myself psyched up for this. We're out here. The whales are here, which should mean the tuna are here. Just got to keep that leader out of the water. Oh, whale, right under my bait, look at that. Holy smokes, come up and have a look at my bait, the old whale, look at that. Oh, don't want to hook one of those guys, don't want to hook one. Mind you, the tuna are about the same size.
They're eating our bait.
Oh, was that a boil there?
No, it might have been him.
Oh yeah, it might have been this guy.
No, they're going to eat our boat.
The whales will pick up the net with the sonar. So they'll come over to it, and the presence of the whales will then bring in the tuna because they know there's a feed going down. It's quite a bizarre thing, actually, setting a net with fish already in it as a fad, you know, a fish aggregation device, essentially.
Come on, tuna. The mackerel's doing his thing.
Yeah, it looks good. It's bang on. Now, this string of floats that I've attached here is to create just a little bit of drag on the line, just enough to help keep that hook in the corner of the mouth. Last time we went with too big a float, and this 1,000 pound cord was snapped just through the sheer inertia and drag and speed created. I mean, you could tow a Land Cruiser with this line and it snapped. Why am I doing this again? Doing it because it's a challenge. And I want to pit myself toe to toe, feel what it's like, you know? No rod and reel. Come on, tuna, I know I'm gonna get ya. Oh, we're bit. We got him on. I don't know, I didn't see the bite. But we've got it.
Tuna.
I don't know, I didn't see the bite. That's a tuna, that's a tuna, that's a tuna. Just be careful of this line.
Hold on, I gotta get the out of here.
No, no, you stay on the helm, Dale. Just gotta be careful, don't walk over those loops of line, whatever you do. Forward, 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 forward. Slowly, 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 I've got the loops of line. The only moment we were looking away, I was just retying my knife on, my safety knife. I looked away for a moment, I turn around, boom. Whoa. Okay, just be careful of these loops of line. Oh boy, the adrenaline is pumping. It is pumping. That one caught us by surprise. Oh, I can't hold it. Okay, just let it go, let it go, let it go, let it go, man. Yeah. Woohoo! The old electric fence reel. It's Kiwi as. It's a little bit of New Zealand here in Canada. Oh, I love this thing. Smoking that hand line.
You taking much?
Yeah, it's taking a bit, man. Oh, there's a big fish on the end of my hand line. Oh, 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 holy. I can feel it. Let it go, mate, let it go, just let it go. Holy show! Oh, I'm getting my work cut out for me here.
This is a comedy. Comedy. From New Zealand to Nova Scotia.
Still taking line, Zap.
Yeah, I know.
Keep coming back, Zap.
I'm going around.
Oh, I'm not sure how much. Going for 10 inch here.
Turn the chair.
I don't know if we've got enough line to be too. Okay, we're just going to turn and chase this fish. We're just about out of line. We're just about down mono, so we have to get some back.
have to, because we've got to bank some line and gauge on another run. It's going to go this way. George, to the chair. We've got to just try and keep as much pressure on as I possibly can, otherwise we're never going to work this fish enough. Yet I don't want to snap off. Oh, there's some fish in there. We've got a big fish on.
I think we know what we got. Moby Dick.
Oh, my arms are starting to burn.
We're getting some back anyway.
Oh, we're getting plenty back now. We're getting plenty back.
It's real, George.
How is it that the wildest man in Nova Scotia is partners with the most mild-mannered man?
We're going to get close to him. Hopefully everything goes good.
The wild man from New Zealand meets the wild man from Nova Scotia.
Gloves are heating up. Hot, hot, hot. Hands are cramping up. Oh man, this is what I asked for. Got a good amount of line back now. Still so much weight, so heavy. It is really like being attached to a car. Oh, I can feel those big beats in the tail. When it pulls like this, it's cramping my forearms up.
It's doing just fine. He's still got his arms.
Only just though, mate, only just. I held him that time. As soon as I pull hard, he pulls back harder.
Yeah, so you can walk a dog or you can drag him. He goes harder when you drag him.
Nice analogy. You should get a fishing show, Dale.
Ain't no small ones here.
Oh, far out. It's getting harder to hold. My hands aren't working so good anymore. Oh. I knew this was gonna hurt. One of those things you do it anyway because it's a challenge. I want to test myself against the biggest and best fish in the world, and to do it in the most primitive way possible, just hook and a line, nothing else between you and the fish. Still got some boogie, Zap. Still got some boogie, mate. Might get wet here, don't you? Nice bit of diesel fumes. Yep.
You can't be too far by the look of the spool, about 100 feet. This is when the fight begins.
Oh, shit. I felt big head shakes. It felt like it. Oh, I might have gone. Nah, got him.
No, he just turned.
Just went real slack. I felt a couple of, like, tears. I think it rolled off of his tail or off his fin. Oh, gosh. That was crushing. I know what it feels like to lose him. It's worse than the pain that's in my arms.
Gotta remember, he's fighting for his life. It's not gonna come easy.
I know. I respect that. Little does he know that we're doing this to promote a fishery that will ultimately save the species, because if it's commercial only, they're as good as gone. So come here, hook up with a guy like Dale, and catch one. That's a hell of a thrill. Don't do it on a fishing rod. Might roll him this time, yeah. Rolled him over. Gotta be careful of now that I'm getting tired. I don't make any mistakes. Get myself tangled. Starting to circle, I think. Here's my line marker, he's 30 feet away. He's not quite done yet. Seen the boat, he didn't like it. I hit my thumb bad then.
a broken one.
Must be a big fish.
You think?
That's the side we want him on, right into the wind.
Stalemate right now. I can't get a rep and he can't pull any. Roll him over with him.
Roll him over.
We're going to see him in a sec. He's coming up on top. I'm ready now for you to come up, fish. Oh, stretching me out.
Where's he at?
Oh, hold him with my ass cheeks. Here we go. Come on. Come up, fish. Come on.
Big fish.
There he is. There he is, big tuna.
There he is. Come on.
There he is. That's a big old tuna. Are you happy with him going under the boat?
It's all right, let him go. Follow him around. Follow him. Oh, what a big fish.
Oh, yes, a big fish.
Follow him around, Max. Boat's smooth. Do them circles.
There he is. Look at that. There's my tuna. There's my tuna. There's my tuna.
Oh,
it's a monster. Oh, yeah, boy. Yeah. 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 I did it.
You did it.
I want to open with him, Zach. Oh, man, I want some text over there.
Right.
Oh, all right. Yeah, it hooks perfectly in the corner of the mouth where we want him. Look at that, that's beautiful. It's a beautiful big tuna. And perhaps the fight of my life. Oh, that's what we come for. We just nailed this trip right there. We just nailed it.
He's an 800 pounder.
He's 800 pounds.
Easy 800.
Oh, it's chilly.
Yeah,
here he
is. Yep.
Roger, look at this.
I hope this is demonstrating the bulk of this fish. Oh,
well, if this doesn't convince you that these fish are big and awesome. Oh, look at the bulk of this thing. I can't even get my legs around it. I can't even get my, I can put a saddle on it and ride it like a bull. It is the bull of the ocean, and at 800 pounds on the average size. That was awesome. You got him? Okay, buddy, thank you very much.
See you later. Give him a touch. Right up to the end.
Push
right
him down.
Up to the end. Stand on him.
Oh, I can feel him taking away under my feet. Oh, we got no kick with his tail. You're going home. You're going home.
Well, if you've enjoyed this episode, but you want more, it's a good thing, because we've got more. More action, including this swordfish that I'm hooked up to right now, as well as tips, tricks, everything from short videos to full episodes, and it's all available free right now on the Ultimate Fishing app or at ultimatefishing.tv.